Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. glad y'all could make it. So today you probably read the title. We're gonna do different things during quarantine to help you feel alive again. Doesn't that sound fun? Okay, yeah, and I'm also doing a voiceover today, so yeah. First things first, you want to grab your pet. You can either go get them, or if they're cool like mine, they will come to you. So one cool thing you can do during quarantine is talk to your pet. Just like get to know them better, check in with them, see like what they're really about. I don't know. Like, I actually learned a lot about Basil just by talking to her. And I'll add in some conversation starters for you guys, just in case. The only thing though is that they don't really understand social cues, so like you might just have to walk out, you know? Another thing you can do is practice making flirty, fun faces in the mirror so you're ready to go when quarantine ends. As you can see here, I'm kind of a pro, so I don't really need any practice, but I did it anyway just to show you guys. And I was so busy making faces, I didn't even realize I was being followed by this little creep. Look at her. Ugh. This next idea is going to involve your pet too, though. So you're going to choreograph a little dance routine and perform it for your pet. This also works with anybody else in your household, you know, mom, dad, brother, sister. Yeah. This has to be my favorite idea that I had. So you're gonna set your house alarm, go to the door that's farthest from the keypad thingy, and open it so it triggers the alarm, and then you're gonna run as fast as you can to type in the code before the alarm goes off. This is like so exhilarating, so fun. Honestly, 10 out of 10. This one's pretty basic. You're just gonna stare out of a window longingly. Doing this with a hot beverage gives you like 10 extra points. For this next activity, you need to go to your basement or any creepy room. Idea number one, just crawl around like you're a freaking animal, psychopath, demon. Basement activity number two, you're gonna try to get somebody to come down to your basement so you can hide and scare them. This has to be my second favorite one because as you can see, I was super hype. Disclaimer though, this only works if the people in your house are actually cool and are willing to get off of the couch to come down to the basement. As you can see, this idea didn't really work out for me, but I wasn't super discouraged because third idea, basement dance party. Yeah. You can make an exception though if you have circumstances like mine, and the scaring can be done out of the basement.
Boo! Did that scare you?
Yeah.
For this next idea, we're gonna take it to the outsides. So you're gonna just go outside, see if there's any humans, and then you're gonna say hi to them, no matter who it is. Hi. I said hi to some builders across the street from me working on a house, and it was honestly really fun, really exhilarating. And the one was also kind of cute, I'm not gonna lie. This one's kind of basic too. You're gonna go on Omegle. Typically this is a big no-no, but just certain time, what is this saying? Okay. Desperate times call for desperate measures. And also this guy was kind of cute. My standards have gone down a lot.
This is fun. Oh, I'm from Singapore, give me a minute. I'm from Pennsylvania. Hey.
It was really good though.
Yup. Okay, we're done with that. Why? It's literally, I've been sweating for the last like 3 hours. Am I okay?
Okay, so that was all the ideas that I had. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know if you have any other ideas down in the comments. And everybody stay safe out there, okay, guys? Okay, see ya later.